This is great coffee, by the way.
Oh, I'm glad you like it.
So we're at your house.
Yes.
And you work from home, which I think is super cool. Art is kind of messy. It's very messy.
Yes.
And it takes up a lot of space.
Yes,
it does. And so you have to be really organized, and you have to make it work, right? Because you, especially when you work in, when you live and work in the same space.
That's right.
It has to be livable.
Yes, you have to clean all the time.
Yeah.
So people are always shocked that I work right here off of my kitchen. Everything is done right here, and really this is the best spot for me because of the natural light.
Yeah.
I can't work anywhere else. It has to be here.
I feel you on
that. I could work in bigger areas, but it's not conducive to working. So I really, really need the windows and the light.
Mm-hmm.
So I have all of my stuff right here, my inks. This is what I work with, alcohol inks.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I have tables, but most of the time I end up actually on the floor.
Oh, that's so awesome.
On the floor. I could have probably three or four tables and I never end up actually using them. I end
really?
Up on the floor.
Oh, just yeah. Like the kids it's just do it, right? Kids have a lot figured out, actually. Like, if you look how kids work,
yeah.
They're so intuitive, they're so impulsive, they go with what catches their eye,
yes.
And they just give her. Mm-hmm. They don't have those thoughts about what stops them or what, you know, like, why not just...
Yeah.
Giver.
Like a Jackson Pollock kind of.
Yes, push, like right? Why not just grab the next thing and go and work fast and work with, they have such exuberance.
Yeah.
And I'm always thinking about why don't I do that? Why don't I?
That's right.
So how about for you? What is it like for you with your process?
A lot of times I actually honestly don't have one. I just sit down and I grab a piece of paper and, you know, don't get me wrong, I have some direction with color that I like to start with.
Yep.
But sometimes what I visualize in my mind will not end up being the same thing, which I think is great.
So let's look at this beautiful piece right here.
Nice. Yeah.
Because this is huge for you, right? Like
it's
huge.
Yes. Yeah, I had the curator from the local hospital come by and just say, you know, we'd like some pieces. And then she said, have you done a 30 by 60 before? And I said, ooh, no, but I'm willing to give it a go.
So take us through your process in terms of what's first, what's second, what's third for your particular
I think
process.
the shape first. So this is all yupo paper
mm-hmm.
and all alcohol ink on yupo. So this took me, I would say about a week just to visualize how I wanted to take it. I took just scrap paper and kind of drew on the panel first the shapes that I wanted to go with and then mm-hmm. just rearranged it
mm-hmm.
in my head so many times actually for this piece.
Mm-hmm.
And then decided on, you know, color and then layering. And even the circles are all hand cut. Like everything is, you know, people say, oh, do you not use a little punch or press? I'm like, nope,
no, why?
Everything's hand done. I just that organic feel.
Yeah, that's what's nice about it because mm-hmm. it's never the same twice, right?
That's
right. It all works together,
yeah.
But it's never the same twice.
Mm-hmm.
Like, are you kind of cutting things out arbitrarily? Are you cutting, did you cut this piece for this spot? I just want to know. I'm just curious.
Yeah, so essentially the main piece is the blue in the background.
Mm-hmm.
So I did that, and then these were my two next pieces, these big pieces here,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
and then the layers on top of that. So I knew in my mind that I wanted these circles to go onto that layer
mm-hmm.
Initially, and then I actually had them overlapping initially, and then I changed my mind and cut them that way, so.
Yeah, it's working,
mm-hmm.
it's really working, so nice. For Dave and I, we met because we had a mutual love of art and we were artists, and then we were using resin, and then we didn't like that brand of resin, and we tried to find something better, and it didn't exist. Mm-hmm. So we kind of are entrepreneurs by accident.
Yeah.
but it's kind of nice that we were artists first because we use the same tools in business as we use as making a painting. And you know, you just get a new idea and it excites you, and you follow that path and see what it'll lead you, and you're kind of always looking for those surprising wins along the journey.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
For sure.
So you can relate to that?
I think so. And it helps for me because my husband is a numbers guy. He's a, you know, business. So he's always churning out, okay, well, you know, how are you going to make money? And where are you getting, you know, what's your cost of materials and your ROI and all these things?
Oh, right? Yeah. He's a realist.
Yeah.
He's your...
That's right. So
does that help you?
It does, because I think as an artist, you can go on this tangent and you're in la la land and you're creating all this stuff, and you know, but at the end of the day, are you making any money? Like, how are you making an income from it? So that's the great thing for me, is because I have e-courses and YouTube and selling online and selling in the community. There's lots of different ways for artists to actually earn a living, not just one avenue or
just
one path.
Your inventory.
There's lots of different ways to, to
earn. Nowadays, for sure.
For sure.
So you just have a diverse portfolio.
That's right.
As your husband might say.
Yes. Don't put all your eggs in one basket, as they say, right?
But
open your mind to other things, even though it's under the umbrella of art, but there's lots of different ways that you can sell online.
Well, and there's
especially with, you know, the little mod minis I sell every month out online.
Perfect.
Every month.
You.
So I sell out. So people are always like, well, how do you do that? But yeah, there's a campaign and strategy and marketing around doing that.
Yeah.
That works for me, and so I think that'll be the next progression is e-courses on how to actually sell art online.
Well, and it all is value, right? You're bringing value in the artwork, and you're bringing value in the know-how.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, like, why not monetize all of that if this is who you are? You're an artist through and through.
Yes.
Make it work for you. I totally agree with that. You know, some people will say like, oh, I don't want to sell my art because I don't want to, you know, take, you know, that piece of myself and sell it. And I say, why the heck not?
Yeah, well, yeah.
My personally, like, I say, why not? Because it's fun, and then you know, you recoup those funds to do it again.
That's right.
So what do you do? So for you, because I know you're constantly posting on Instagram.
Yes.
You make amazing YouTube tutorials. What have you learned from that experience? What works? What doesn't work? What what's your kind of go-to, or what's your advice about all of that sort of realm?
Yeah, I think each platform is different. You know, the people that are on Instagram that follow me are different to those on YouTube. So you have to have different tactics of how you reach and communicate with those people. But for Instagram, because it's obviously so visual, you have to know how to take, you know, just the right picture. I mean, I just go over here at my table where there's natural light, or even here, and just really hone in on the picture or post that I want to focus on. And just make sure you have a nice, clear, bright picture that everybody, you know, is inspired by. I don't think you have to post like 6 times a day. That's not necessary.
No, that might actually be a turnoff.
I think so. Yeah, just 2 times, 3 times a day, I think, is all you need, really.
Yeah.
And I'm always talking with people every day on each of those platforms, and I get so many questions that I've just come to a point where I'm just going to make e-courses and showcase all of these things. So I love putting together the video and the editing portion of it, and just creating that type of product for people. Being online, I think people just think it's easy. You just throw your stuff up there and it's gonna sell, and everyone's gonna find you, but it doesn't work that way. Even on social media, I think you still have to reach out to people, connect with people. There's still strategy in how you sell online, which is huge, and a lot of people don't understand that. They have all these pieces of beautiful art, and they just don't know how to go about selling it online.
Yeah, artists are, you know, for better or for worse, they're artists.
That's right.
They're not necessarily marketers, and they don't necessarily have a business sense. And I think that's where the gallery model has always come into play.
Yes.
For someone to take this work and sell it to the people who are willing to purchase it. So my question to you is, because not everybody cares to share.
No, people are worried. I think artists are scared to share their information. And to be honest with you, I don't know why. I think if you want people to respect you as a brand and a person, I think there's nothing wrong with sharing that with others. I think it goes a long way. And if you're confident in your own work and your abilities, then you really have nothing else to worry about. I know a lot of people, if I show them this technique or I do that, then they're just gonna copy me and steal.
Yeah.
And you know what, the world is a big place. If someone's actually going to copy you, then they're gonna do it regardless. And you can't worry about those things. You just have to move forward with your own. I mean, if you're worried about that stuff, you're never going to move forward with your own brand and your own focus and your own art.
I think ultimately, how closely can you really copy a signature?
Well, like, you can't, and especially this medium, alcohol ink, you can't duplicate it.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I don't even think I could replicate that again if I tried.
And I know this from being an art teacher all those years. I would, you know, create an assignment for my students and say, okay, we're all gonna do alcohol ink on yupo paper, and it's gonna be a collaged piece with art resin on top.
Yeah.
And everybody's would look completely different.
That's right.
At the end.
Yeah,
right?
Even if they were all doing the same style, it would all look different.
And sometimes it would be like, I would see some kids working, I'd be like, oh, I never thought of that. I never knew that that was something that you would interpret from what the assignment, you know, kind of was.
Yeah, that's right.
So that's the best part about art to me, though. It's so exciting that, you know, everybody's going to put their own spin on it and, you know, have their own signature on it, and bring out something, bring something to life that was yes. not alive before.
That's right.
So you don't sell through galleries.
No, but I think it's a great, you know, way to go if that's what you'd like to do.
Yeah, it works.
It does work.
It's sort of the older model, but it still yeah. works, right?
And I think you have to look at different avenues of selling, especially if you want to gain the exposure. Mm-hmm.
But do you, like, do you sell on Etsy or Amazon Handmade or any of these sites?
I don't use any of those sites. I know Etsy is very popular, mm-hmm. but I personally like to be in control of my own destiny. I have my own website and I do everything myself. Within Wix, it's just an entire umbrella of automated email marketing, your email list. Everybody knows mm-hmm. the money is in the list. Mm-hmm. And people forget that when you're on Instagram and YouTube and Facebook, we don't own those accounts.
Right.
We're just using it to reach people. And somebody posed the question, what will happen if all of those platforms shut down? How are you going to
make... Oh my God, I'll have so much more time.
Right?
Kind of want that to happen now that you make that suggestion.
How will you make money?
Yeah.
If you don't have your list,
yeah.
how are you going to connect with those people?
Good point.
So you have to have a way to build a list.
Yeah.
And you know, you use those platforms as a vehicle to do that. So once you've generated that list, then you can communicate with those people and sell to those people. But you can't do that without a list.
Right.
It's the most important thing about online selling.
So
the number one thing.
Yeah.
If I could give any advice to anybody about selling, you have to have a list. What is going to drive people to actually sign up for your list? What kind of value are you offering to people mm-hmm. that will make them want to buy from you down the road, right? Mm-hmm. So important.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the internet has given sort of, it's flipped sales models on their head. Mm-hmm. Whereas you used to have to, you know, you would walk in and drop your money in exchange for goods.
Yeah.
Now it's like, I'm gonna give you stuff for free in the hopes that you will give me your attention.
That's right.
And the yeah, more you give absolutely. Me your attention,
yeah.
the more chances that you might buy from me.
That's right.
But you build community when you do that, which I think is such an exciting thing for artists.
Yes.
Because, yeah, people who are genuinely interested in you or like ArtResin or whatever, they are interested in that world. Mm-hmm. Right? So they want to see what you do, they want to know what you do, they want to, like, you know, they it's inspiring.
Yes.
And you know, artists need other artists to be inspired.
They do.
To keep the inspiration going. Okay. Being an artist, you're used to problem solving and you're used to having a vision where it's not perfectly clear where you're going, but you're courageous enough to venture down a certain path. You know, you trust your own creativity enough to know that, you know, we can figure this out. And mm-hmm. it's a worthwhile journey. It's
yeah.
exciting. And
yeah.
you know, like that whole road less traveled thing mm-hmm. is the same road less traveled for an artist as it is for an entrepreneur. You know, being an artist, you do need to make the numbers work in order to keep your business alive. Mm-hmm. But you also need to have fun in order to keep your business alive.
Yeah, you have to wear all hats too as an artist. That's the thing that I think a lot of people who are creative don't understand, that you have to be doing all of those things though, even the things that you don't like, in order to be successful, right? Mm-hmm.
Like you constantly need to figure things out
yes.
in order for your brain to be stimulated. And I think that's why people like creativity, is because
yeah.
you're always figuring out new things
yes.
and having these wins along the way.
Yeah. Yeah, see, that's a great combination right there. The green and the yellow.
Yeah, I like
it. And it looks like a face. You're making a face.
There. This is how I feel in your studio.
Yeah.
Happy.